This is Copper. You know what Copper and I have in common? We feel fear. Copper and other dogs may be scared of not getting walked enough or getting held too long. Humans, on the other hand, are scared of things like public speaking or unwanted surprise birthday parties. For wild animals, things are a little different. Wild animals are scared of things like getting torn to shreds and eaten alive by predators. Let's just agree that if you saw a tiger on the prowl across the street, you would be unlikely to have a picnic in your front yard. If, on the other hand, you were on your roof of your house, you might just pull out a bucket of chicken and watch the show. Turns out animals are the same way, and studies have shown that when animals are near or within habitat that provides refuge from predators, they're more likely to eat more. After all, this is what animals want to be doing anyway. They want to maximize their energy intake so that they can have lots of adorable babies and be very fit. Of course, refuge habitat doesn't exist everywhere. It can be very variable across the landscape, and so when animals are not near refuge, they have to be watching out for predators and thus may eat less. This creates what researchers call a landscape of fear, in which the feeding behavior of prey varies across a landscape where refuge also varies. We don't know much about the landscape of fear in coral reefs, even though reef fish feeding behavior is responsible for cleaning the reef of algae, which can otherwise destroy the reef and take away everything that we love about it. So I was studying the landscape of fear in coral reefs. To do this, we put out these adorable little clumps of algae all over the place in this patchy reef landscape, and we come back over time and measure how much gets eaten. The idea here is that the more isolated from refuge habitat the clump of algae would be, the less we would expect the fish to eat it because there are things like sharks lurking among the reef patches that could eat the fish. So one day, Julie and I are snorkeling around for about 8 hours collecting data for this study. We head back to the boat just in time to watch a beautiful Marin sunset before the sun slips down below the horizon. We've got just enough time to make it back to the station, and we are ready to go to town on some serious dinner. We got the boat in full throttle, we're booking it to get home. Just before we're about to start crossing the really wide bay before the research station, all of a sudden, the boat engine completely dies. We try to fix it and realize very quickly that we don't have the right tools on board. Also, right around this time, we realize that we are slowly drifting out to sea as the tide recedes. Isn't that special? We have two options. One, swim to the nearest shore, which is quite a hike from the research station, and if we do this, we're going to be required to either walk for a really long time in our wet gear and suffer the risk of extreme chafing, or hitchhike and ruin the interior of some nice person's car. Option two would be to swim across the bay. Bear in mind, this bay is about 120 feet deep, and at night, it's ink black. You can see nothing. And there certainly could be tiger sharks in the bay. Not a very good idea. We go with option two. We jump in, we each take a piece of the anchor line, wrap it around our shoulders, and we team swim the boat back. We just spent all day thinking about and studying how predators like sharks scare reef fish into not eating when they're in particularly exposed habitats. And we just left the safe haven of our boat to enter a very exposed habitat, and we're unable to eat dinner until we get this boat back to the research station. We're swimming, all you can see is pitch black. A little bit of a gut check, just keep swimming. The swim felt like it took hours, but it was about 35 minutes. We swim to the dock, we collapse, we're exhausted, but we are very relieved that we were not a tiger shark snack. They say don't take your work home with you, sometimes it's unavoidable.